In this segment, we are going to talk about how we use numerical methods to solve higher order or coupled ordinary differential equations. Because if you recall, the methods we've been talking so far, such as Euler's method and Runge-Kutta second order method and Runge-Kutta fourth order method, they all solve the differential equation of this particular form. So you're given a first order differential equation which can be written in this particular form, and you're given some initial condition at some point, and that's the equation, differential equation, which you can solve by using the Runge-Kutta second order method, Runge-Kutta fourth order method, or Euler's method. So what this may make you believe is that all these methods are only good for first order ordinary differential equations. How do we go about solving higher order differential equations or coupled ordinary differential equation? Is there a way to get around it? Because all the methods we have talked so far can only solve a first order ordinary differential equation. So what we'll do is we'll take it through an example, and that's the best thing to do. So let's suppose somebody gives us a differential equation, a second order differential equation like this, says, hey, you got 3 times the second derivative of y plus 2 times the first derivative with respect to y plus 5y is equal to 7 e to the power minus x. And now here you need two initial conditions, y sub 0 equal to, let's suppose equal to 11, and dy by dx at 0 is equal to 13, let's suppose. So we are given here a second order differential equation. This is no longer a first order differential equation like we have been solving by using the numerical methods we have done so far. But here we have a second order ordinary differential equation. It cannot be written in this form directly. So we've got to figure out how can we solve a differential equation which is second order or higher, or which is coupled. So let's talk about coupled ordinary differential equations a little bit later. Now, the way to solve this particular problem is a second order differential equation. What we have to figure out is that we need to somehow reduce it to a first order differential equation so that we can use the methods which we have learned so far, such as Euler's method and the Runge-Kutta methods. And one of the ways to do it is as follows. What we'll do is we'll assume dy by dx equal to z. So we say let dy by dx equal to z. As soon as we assume dy by dx is equal to z, what we can do now is that we can substitute for anywhere there is a dy by dx, we'll substitute z, or anywhere there is the second derivative of y with respect to x square, I will call it the first derivative with respect to z. Okay. So for dy by dx, any sign of dy by dx, instance of dy by dx, I will substitute by z, and the second derivative of y with respect to x by first derivative of z. So if I do that, see what will happen to this particular equation here. This will become, I'll have the second order differential, this particular second order differential equation become 3 dz by dx. This one. Then instead of dy by dx, I'll put z plus 2z plus 5y is equal to 7 e to the power minus x. So that's what I get as the reduction of this differential equation once I make these substitutions there. And I can really see that, hey, this is nothing but a first-order differential equation in terms of z. That's what we have. This is a first-order ordinary differential equation with z as the dependent variable and x as the independent variable. So we have somehow been able to reduce the second-order differential equation to a first-order differential equation. But it does not happen alone. It also happens by taking this into combination, because y is our original independent variable. So we cannot just simply solve this for z and y, because there's only one differential equation here, and so we need to couple it with this particular ordinary differential equation and solve both of them simultaneously to be able to use the methods we have learned so far for solving first order ordinary differential equations, such as by Euler's method and Runge-Kutta method. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rewrite these two differential equations. So we have, this is number one and this is number two differential equation. Let's also see that in order to be able to solve a first-order ordinary differential equation, which is coupled now, this one is coupled with this one, we do need a corresponding initial condition. So here, the initial condition will go to for y. So y sub 0 is 11. So that means that this will be corresponding to y sub 0 equal to 11. That's what I'll be using there. Now, here is a dz by dx, so I need an initial condition on the variable, independent variable z. So I would use this one. because I'll have dy by dx at 0 equal to 13, which simply implies that z sub 0 is equal to 13, because that's how z has been defined. So that's how these things are going to get coupled together. So I'm going to rewrite these, that what these two coupled ordinary differential equations are, in addition to the initial conditions which are required to solve that. So if I rewrite that, I'll get the first order differential, the first equation of the two coupled equations which I have to write, that dy by dx is equal to z, and that the initial value of y, which I need corresponding to this, y sub 0 will be equal to 11. And the second one will be that I have dz by dx. I'm going to simplify it. I get 7 e to the power minus x minus 2z minus 5y divided by 3 by rewriting the equation just in terms of dz by dx. And the initial condition corresponding to this would be z sub 0 equal to 13. So that's the second first-order ordinary differential equation. Now, both of these need to be solved simultaneously because you have y here and a z here and a z here and a y there. So both of these need to be solved simultaneously to be able to find out what the value of y is at a particular point which you are interested in. So that's how you reduce your higher-order differential equations to set of first-order differential equations which are coupled, and to then to be able to solve it.